Nala and Damayanti. Once Nala, a powerful Nishadha king with a vast kingdom, caught a swan who told him about Damayanti, the daughter of the king of Vidarbha. The swan went to Damayanti and told her about the handsome Nala. The king invited everyone to her Swayamvar, including Nala. On the way, several gods asked him to plead with her on their behalf, and he did. But she garlanded Nala at the ceremony. The jealous gods made Nala lose everything in gamble. Nala and Damayanti sent their children to her parents while they roamed forests. One day, feeling guilty, Nala went away. Damayanti returned to Vidarbha after much suffering. Nala had become ugly. He became Bahuka and served the king Rituparna of Ayodhya, who taught him proper gambling. Damayanti held a fake second Swayamvar, knowing Nala would come. Nala went with his master. Damayanti recognized him. He won back his kingdom and they lived happily. Awaiting Arjuna's return, the Pandavas and Draupadi waited for 5 years for Arjuna to return. These years were spent visiting various pilgrim sites with sage Lomasa and Dhaumya. They heard the stories about sages, kings, demons to build up their courage and patience. These were some of those stories. Agastya Rishi saw some of the spirits of his ancestors hanging upside down. They said if Agastya would marry and have children, then he and they would all be set free from life and death. The king of Vidarbha came for Agastya's blessings to have a child. The sage said that he would have a daughter who would marry Agastya. The king's daughter Lopamudra grew up, married Agastya and went to live in the forest with him. Lopamudra wanted a family, but they were too poor to look after children. She requested Agastya to earn enough wealth. Agastya began to look around for a way to earn some income. Ilvala, the demon. When he couldn't find any source of income, Agastya decided to get his wealth from the wicked demon Ilvala. Ilvala and his brother Vatapi hated Brahmanas and had a plan for killing them. Ilvala would invite a Brahmana for dinner. He would magically change Vatapi into a goat and serve its meat to the Brahmana. When dinner was over, Ilvala would ask Vatapi to come out, and Vatapi would come out of the Brahmana ripping him apart. Agastya knew this, so he went along with the plan and was invited to dinner. He ate Vatapi the goat and digested him. When Ilvala called his brother, Agastya told him he had been digested and there was no way to bring him back. Ilvala's trick was over. He bowed before Agastya and gave him the wealth he needed for Lopamudra. She was blessed with a good and learned son. Rishyasringa. Rishyasringa was the pure and learned son of Vibhandaka, who had an ashrama in a forest. Once there was a famine in the kingdom of Anga nearby. King Romapada was advised to bring Rishyasringa to the city. His purity would cause rains to come to the area where he lived. The king sent beautiful girls to lure Rishyasringa to the city. The learned Rishyasringa came, and as was predicted, rain poured over the land. The king was so happy that he gave his daughter Shanta in marriage to Rishyasringa. When he learned that Vibhandaka was coming looking for his son to the city, he welcomed him with gifts of cattle and wealth and servants. Vibhandaka saw his son and his son's beautiful wife. His anger vanished and he blessed the couple, asking Rishyasringa to return to the forest after his son was born, and he had completed the king's task.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.